Beware the Jabberwock, my son. The jaws that bite, the claws that catch. Beware the Jubjub bird, and shun the frumious Bandersnatch. He took his vorpal sword in hand. Long time the manxome foe he sought. The Jabberwock with eyes of flame came whiffling through the tulgey wood.
Oh, hi, Rachel.
Mom wants Angela to get ready for bed, and she says it's time for Charles to go home. Go brush your teeth, Angela. It's just a book. People don't actually go through mirrors. Here, play a song on your music box. It'll make you feel better.
So I was thinking, my dad said I could borrow a car from the dealership. There's this place that people go to.
And what would we do? Angela, are you almost done in there? Angela? Angela, what is it?
This doesn't look so bad, does it? I'm not sure what's going on. I spoke to your aunt just 2 days ago and told her we'd be here this morning. Is this normal for her?
We don't know.
I don't know what we're gonna do if she's not here.
We could go back home.
Hello! I'm Charles. I'm a friend of Beth's. I live down the road. I was supposed to be here when you arrived, but I overslept. I'm sorry.
It's all right.
You must be Olivia and Claire.
Is their aunt home?
She should be.
I was knocking.
Well, she's a little slow getting around. She's... not well.
Oh.
But let's go inside and we'll find her.
maybe a few days we're gonna find your dad. Just a few days.
It's all right, Claire Bear. Everything's gonna be all right.
Hi, you must be Beth. Excuse me. I'm sorry, is everything all right?
I don't want them here.
What?
What I mean is, I think it would be best if you took them.
Yes, that's not possible. I thought I explained all this to you on the phone.
Who are you again?
Camilla Clark. I worked with their mother. Is there some sort of problem? Because when we talked to
you... The problem is, I don't normally entertain visitors.
They're not just visitors. They're your nieces. Their mother's just died. Your own sister. My husband and I are moving clear across the country in a matter of days. All of our things are packed. We can't take them with us, not under these circumstances.
What about their father?
He's working out of the country somewhere. We haven't been able to reach him. I guess he and Rachel have been divorced for some time.
I wouldn't know.
We've been trying to contact him, but we just haven't been able to yet. I'm sure as soon as we do, he'll want to come straight back to collect the girls. In the meantime, considering all they've been through, I really think the best thing for them is to be with family.
Don't mind your aunt. She acts a little different sometimes, but she means well. She's a very extraordinary person. But she's been through a lot in her life.
We should form a club.
Well, girls, I'm afraid I have to be going. Your father will be here soon, I'm sure. And in the meantime, if you girls need anything, anything at all, don't hesitate to call, okay? I'll let myself out. Goodbye.
This is your Aunt Angela's room.
The one who died?
Unless you have another Aunt Angela no one's told me about. It's the only other room in the house with a bed in it at the moment, so you'll have to share. I didn't want you to come here. And by your expressions, I can only gather that the feeling is mutual. But you're here, and while you are, there are some rules you'll need to follow.
No one in the kitchen between mealtimes. Everyone in your rooms by 10, lights out by 11.
There's an elevator there, but it's broken and dangerous. Stay out of it.
There is a bathroom adjacent to your room, so there should be no reason for anyone to come out until morning. That is my study. No one is to go in there. This door leads to the basement. It stays locked at all times.
Why?
Because the basement has rats. Any more questions? This is the dining room. The kitchen is just there. If you hear any noises in the night, ignore them. It's an old house, and besides, I have a tendency to sleepwalk, so it's probably just me bumping into something or knocking it over. If I see either of you wandering the house after hours, there will be consequences. Are all those rules clear?
Yes. Claire, do you mind asking Lucy B if she understands the rules?
She says she does.
Since the accident, she doesn't like to talk to strangers. The doctors say it's perfectly normal for a girl her age who's been through...
It's a weakness, and weakness is not good.
Well, I have some work to do. I assume you girls can entertain yourselves until dinner time? Good.
Oh, hello.
I was just looking around.
No, it's fine.
What are you doing?
Planting some flowers. Pansies. You can eat these, you know.
Do you live here?
No. But, I do come over a lot to help out with things.
Like gardening?
Yes. I suppose I enjoy participating in the miracle of creating new life in some small way. And I never had any children of my own, so I guess in a small way, I look on these little flowers as my children. You might want to get ready for dinner. We'll be eating soon.
Okay.
Girls like this? It's actually an African recipe. Don't worry, there's nothing strange in it. It's mostly just chicken and vegetables. Your Aunt Beth would live on toast and tea if left to herself. Well, bon appetit. We're honored you could tear yourself away from your work long enough to join us.
What is this?
It's that African stew. You like it. I got you something.
They had it.
They did.
What's that?
A book. On late Coptic necromancy.
On history. It's a book on history. So, what do you girls like to do for fun?
I don't know. Stuff.
Stuff. I enjoy stuff. Maybe once you're settled in, we can find some fun stuff to do.
They're not going to be here that long.
I know that, but that doesn't mean that while they're here, they can't have a good time.
So, you two have known each other for a long time?
since we were kids, younger than you. Yep, everyone knew about the Molnars around here. Especially your Aunt Beth.
Why's that?
Because your Aunt Beth won a very prestigious violin competition.
Really?
When she was only 10.
Is that true?
He talks too much.
It's absolutely true, and she knows it. Claire, you haven't eaten anything.
You better eat. Lucy B would like this. It has carrots. Come on. See, it isn't too bad. What's in this?
Chicken, vegetables, some spices. I use a little peanut butter to thicken the sauce. Why? 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 Olivia! Claire, breathe, breathe. Claire, Claire, breathe. Claire, breathe. Try and breathe. Okay, it's okay, it's okay. What do we do? What do we do?
Do.
She gonna be all right?
I should have told you she has a severe peanut allergy.
I'm so sorry.
Can't. Aunt Beth told us not to go in there. Mommy. My mommy. How? It's locked.
Thank you.
I don't want to. Is that you? Where are you? Then can I see you? Mirror, mirror, open wide. Let this spirit come inside. Mirror, mirror, open wide. Let this spirit come inside.
open wide and let the spirit come inside. Mommy? Mommy? Claire? Claire! Hiding.
From what?
From Aunt Beth. She wants to hurt me.
What are you talking about? Aunt Beth doesn't want to hurt you. Come on.
Please, don't let her get me.
Nobody wants to get you, Claire.
I'll show you.
We can't go in there. What are you doing?
Here it is.
This must be what I saw in the mirror. How did you know about this?
Mom told me.
Hello? Mrs. Clark, this is Olivia McCallum.
Hi, Olivia. How's it going?
We need to get out of here.
You gotta get over here now.
What's going on?
I just found an article saying that Aunt Beth murdered somebody.
You're not eating any food?
I'm not really that hungry. Sorry.
Someone else, on the other hand, is turning into a ravenous little tiger.
I'm glad to hear that. I was worried about her. You know, I was thinking, Now that we've had a chance to get to know each other a little better, it might be nice for you girls to stay a little longer. We are family, after all.
That's very nice of you, but I'm sure my father would want to get us right away.
From what I've heard, your father's pretty hard to reach right now.
Well, our friend reached him, so it's okay. He should be here in a few days.
I see. Well, maybe we should ask Claire what she thinks, now that she's feeling better. What do you think, Claire? Would you like to stay here, in this house, for a while? So, you'd like to stay here instead of going with your father?
Yes.
What are you doing, Claire?
I want to get it out. 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 I want to get it out.
Stop that!
What's wrong with her?
I don't know.
I'll go get Charles.
No!
To take her to the hospital. How is she?
She's sleeping now.
Well, Charles brought his car.
Okay, then I'll go get her.
There's no need to wake her. I'll carry her down. You go wait in the car.
Where's Claire?
She went into the basement, didn't she? I could see it in her eyes. It's the same look Angela had. Get her phone. Get her phone.
No. Get off me.
Hold her still. Come on. Take it. Oh, get your gun!
Okay!
Thank you.
Everything okay?
Yeah, there's been a change in plans. I'm gonna pick up the
phone. Well, they're asleep right now, so it's probably not the best time. I love you, so.
I'm gonna pick them up in the morning for first things. Okay.
Travel safe. Yeah.
No.
I found this under the... You should leave.
You'd like that, wouldn't you? I know all about you.
I don't think you know what you...
Shut up! Go get the girls. Go! You try anything, she dies. Where's Claire? She's in there. Go get her. Don't look at her. Just go get Claire.
You're a courageous woman. Foolish, but courageous. I admire that.
I don't give a shit what you admire.
We didn't do anything to her.
Get down there!
You can't take her away from here. It won't let you.
Just go!
No, I don't want to go.
Claire, come on.
No!
Come on.
No!
You'll feel better soon, Claire.
No!
Mommy's dead, Claire.
I know. But she's coming back.
Back where?
Into the world.
Let's get out of here.
I want Lucy B.
Claire, we have to go.
Please. I need Lucy B.
Okay, it's fine. Just be quick. Right? She's gonna go get Lucy. Everything's gonna be okay.
Where is your sister?
She's gone.
And your friend? I was about your same age when I first learned the truth about this house. And I can assure you, I felt very much the same way you do right now.
What is happening?
The first thing you need to know is that your sister Claire is completely innocent. Everything she's doing right now is because of it.
It?
This house is inhabited by an entity of extreme malevolence. It's using your sister to free itself and get back into the world. Yes, it says, there are three doors. The mirror is the first door. It leads to the mind. The mind is the second door. It leads to the body. The body is the third door. It leads to the world and to destruction. That thing is using your sister as a vessel. Taking shape inside her, just like it did inside Angela.
So that's why you killed her?
Yes. But only after I saw what she had done to our parents.
Then it was self-defense?
Of course it was. What else would it be?
You were not going to kill my sister.
Of course not. Why do you think I came back here, to this house, after they released me? To find a way to finally defeat it. To find a way not to kill.
Where do you think she would be?
She won't go far. It won't let her. No. It needs to keep her safe. She'll be somewhere in this house.
Can I ask you something?
Of course.
In the paper, it said that you were a person of interest in Angela's killing?
Yeah. That's what they said.
Well?
Well, what?
Were you there? Did you see Aunt Beth kill Aunt Angela?
Yeah. I was there. And no, I didn't see your Aunt Beth kill your Aunt Angela. We were both there. But it was me. Me who...
But you never went to jail.
I ran before the cops got there. But not your aunt. She thought if she could just tell them the truth, they'd believe her. They interrogated her for over 14 hours. She could have implicated me at any time, bargained for a better deal. She never did. She never even mentioned my name.
She spent the better part of her young adult life in a mental hospital while I graduated high school, went to college, got married, got divorced. I owe her my life. There you are. So, you think you're up for this?
Who are you? No. Claire? Claire? Claire, stop! Stop, please! Get this thing out of her.
Not long.
Yeah. You just need something that belongs to your sister.
Her bunny.
Perfect.
I'll have the two of you go get it.
Yeah.
Okay.
It should be in here. No! No, no, no! No! Let me have her! Please! Get away from her.
Olivia.
What did you do to her?
We just gave her a sedative to relax her.
Put down the knife.
Olivia.
Put it down! You said you were gonna help her.
I wish I could help her. For more than 15 years, I have tried to find a way to help her and others like her. But I failed.
You lied to me.
I had no choice. If this thing gets out, many more people will die. It says in the book, only through death will the third door be closed. We have to do this.
Give me the knife.
Take her out of here.
Are you really gonna let her do this? Are you really gonna let her kill Claire because something she read in a book?
Don't listen to her.
Think! Do you really want the death of another little girl in your conscience?
You know this has to be done.
Another way.
There is no other way. And you know that!
No, I don't. All I know is what you've told me.
Don't be a fool.
I'm sorry.
You were always weak.
You don't know what you're doing!
She's not evil, you know. She loved Angela, and she loves your sister, too. She just believes what she's saying.
What about you? What do you believe?
I don't know. All I know is that when Angela died, that thing was gone. Well, not gone, it was just back in its cage anyway. You're probably hungry. I'll make you some food. No peanut butter.
Wait.
Are you sure about this?
No, but what other choice do we have?
Take that many?
My stomach hurts.
How's she holding up?
Like you'd expect, stubbornly insisting that she's right.
that we couldn't possibly have sent that thing back using peanut butter.
Then how does she explain Claire?
I don't think she can, to be honest. It's enough to get you by until your dad gets back. Beth asked me to give it to you.
That's all right.
Take it. I think it's the easiest way for her to say she's sorry. Where will you go?
Back to our old house for now.
Girls your age shouldn't be on their own.
I think we'll survive.
Well, let me give you a lift anyway. It's the least I can do.
You couldn't find her?
No. But it's okay. I don't need her anymore.
Great. Let's go then.
Happening.
Wait, wait. I read something here. Yes, here. It is possible, if the third door be not fully closed, in traveling from the realms of elemental darkness, a spirit may become caught between two worlds. Tethered to their place of origin until such time as they are able to complete their journey. Oh, that must be it. That's why it still wants Claire. And that's why it's able to touch us, to affect us physically. Even though we still can't see it.
I did see it. And I think I heard it.
That means maybe we can kill it. But we need something first.
What?
In the kitchen. can't find it!
What happened?
She's gone. It took her. Claire? I don't see her. She's not here. The basement!
She's upstairs!
Thank you.
spirit, come inside. Mirror, mirror, open wide. Let the spirit come inside.
Don't let her say the
mirror,
words.
Mirror, open wide. Let the spirit come
Claire!
Inside.
Don't say the words!
Let this spirit come inside.
Beth, no.
Mirror, mirror, open wide. Let this spirit come inside. Mirror, mirror, open wide. Let this spirit come inside.
No.
Yeah, Beth, I can't do this.
Do it.
I can't. No, please. No.
Can I speak to her alone?
I just want you to know my sister had nothing to do with any of
it.
This is being reported as a murder-suicide.
Let's get him out of here.
Livy?
What?
Is Aunt Beth really dead?
Yeah, but she saved us. But we aren't gonna talk about that to anybody, okay?
Libby?
What?
I love you.
I love you too, Claire Bear.